Thank you for your interest in TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code. The following video will introduce you to a new product from TMS Software that might just be the tool you need to develop applications for the web. After watching this video, you'll have a good impression of what TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code is all about. I'll start by listing all its key characteristics and will then follow up with the product itself, introducing the development environment, some key components, and how to get started with the product. I'm quite certain that after watching this video, you'll be able to download the software to your computer and start building your first web application. So without further ado, let's start looking at the key characteristics of TMS Web Core. So in order to form an opinion if TMS Web Core is the product for you, I collected a couple of questions. Are you looking for a rapid application development tool for web client applications? And you might have additional requirements when you build these applications. For example, you would like to use an object-oriented programming language and not a script language or a language that is interpret while it is being executed. You want an application that is compiled and you can be certain that when executed inside of the web browser, doesn't have any runtime errors caused by incorrect types, etc. Also, rapid application development should allow you to use common concepts and components that are part of a toolkit. You do not want to reinvent the wheel for every application that you develop. Furthermore, this toolkit should include common user interface controls that are common for web user interfaces. It would also be beneficial if you could access any web service, be it a REST web service or older SOAP XML web services. And even better, maybe this toolkit even has some common cloud services already included, for example, Google Maps or Google Charts. Also, as JavaScript is very popular in the web world, it would be great if you could include existing frameworks and libraries. And finally, as deployment is always underestimated when it comes to effort to deploy an application on a customer system, it would be great if any web server could be used and there wasn't any special configuration needed for your application. So Xcopy deployment would be preferred. Look no farther, because TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code fulfills all these requirements. Part of TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code is an integrated development environment, or IDE, built in Visual Studio Code. It comes with a visual page designer, a component library, and an intelligent source code editor with templates, code navigation, and automatic completion. As programming language, you will use Object Pascal. This web development framework built by TMS is referred to as TMS Web Core. Right now, you can build three different web application types: classic web client applications that you deploy onto a web server and can be accessed using a web browser. Furthermore, particularly useful in a mobile environment are the so-called progressive web applications, short PWA. And even without being online, you can use the web application because it is being cached inside of your device. And finally, with the help of the Electron framework, you can build desktop applications for Windows, macOS, and Linux using TMS Web Core. At its core, you build a web client application and it can be bundled as a native Windows, macOS, or Linux application. Be aware that you need a macOS computer in order to create macOS applications. This is a restriction from Apple and not from the framework. And just to put it out there, Visual Studio Code is an application that uses the Electron framework. You can, however, generate Linux applications from a Windows system, for example. So without giving you any more slides, let's look at the product itself. As said before, TMS Web Core integrates into the Visual Studio Code environment. On the left sidebar, you get additional options to create the different types of TMS Web Core applications. Let's have a look at the IDE in detail, creating a new web application. This is the Visual Designer, which is your gate to the rapid application development. On the right, you see the available components, and here on the left, you see the property window to configure these controls after they have been dropped on the form. You can specify properties which describe the appearance and behavior of a control, and the events describe what happens if the user interacts with these controls. Each page in your web application becomes a unit in Object Pascal, and each unit has a Pascal file with the source code, an HTML file for additional web design, and a DFM file. DFM file is Object Pascal specific. It contains all the information what is being shown on your form. Furthermore, you have a project HTML file. The default name is project1.html, which is the access to your web application. Usually, you will rename this to index.html. Furthermore, you have a project file with the ending dpr and dproject for compatibility reasons with other IDEs. So in addition to the designer, you also have the source code with the class definition and your implementation. This is Object Pascal source code. Looking at the tool palette, you can see what controls are already available and included with TMS Web Core. All the standard HTML controls are also available as TMS Web Core controls. But it doesn't end here. The controls get more complex the farther more you go down in the tool palette. For example, you have a complete toolbar control to build toolbars in your web applications. You have grid controls, and you have specific controls for tabular data like the TWeb table control. And going farther down, you also have controls to access other web services and cloud services. For example, Google Chart, PayPal for bank transfers that you want to include inside of your application, reCAPTCHA controls. And then of course you have controls for responsive web design. Even more sophisticated controls that make application development easier are controls to show Google Maps, integrate with Google Drive, show YouTube videos, and also display a Twitter feed. But TMS Web Core goes even farther. I also mentioned that TMS Web Core makes it easy to interact with any web service, and not only those web services that have been embedded into components. So here you see, for example, the TWeb HTTP request to access any HTTP resource on the web. Finally, the standard TMS XData access controls are also included in TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code, so that you, if you're already a TMS customer, can easily include your XData web services into your web client applications that you will build with Visual Studio Code. In order to show you what rapid application development means, I'm going to give you a brief introduction. I'm well aware that you won't be able to build applications just from this short example. However, there are quite a few tutorials and blog posts, and of course the documentation about TMS Web Core available on the webpage from TMS Software. But remember, this video is not supposed to teach you how to use TMS Web Core in detail. It will just show you how efficient you will be building web applications using TMS Web Core and how much time you save not reinventing the wheel each time you build an application. So let's just use the Twitter component, typing Twitter in the tool palette. We select the TWeb Twitter feed, click on the form, and here we have the TWeb Twitter feed component on the form. Now we have the ability to change all the properties in the object inspector. For feed, we select one of the most important feeds on the internet, and that's it. Now you're already ready to run your application. For this, you go here on the left side on the little bug with the run arrow and click run. TMS Web Core launches the browser for you, enters the correct URL, and here's your application with your Twitter control as you created it. And that is exactly the idea behind rapid application development. Not to do the same thing over and over again, but wrap it into common controls and components that you use each time you build an application. And this concept is not only possible on the design surface, but also in code. So instead of assigning the properties here in the designer, you can also, for example, double click on the form, which goes to the form create event. This event is executed when your page is created, but you can also write web Twitter feed 1, which is the name of the control, dot, press enter because it's automatically completed, dot feed equals possum every hour. And this is all in Pascal terminology. And again, run your application and you should see the same result as before. There you go. The only difference is that we assigned the property in code and not in the designer. You can switch between the code and the designer easily using a hotkey, as easy as Control F12. Using this basic approach, dropping controls on the form and then adding properties and customizing events. For example, if you drop a button on the form, you have an on-click event, which is executed each time the user clicks on the button. So you can implement it easily by double-clicking here, and all the code and everything is being inserted automatically into your file. Then you can say show message, which is a Pascal method, hello world, exclamation mark, and end your line with a semicolon. Then again, run your application and the control is added to the page. You click it and your code is executed. Hopefully this video got you interested in TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code. Just go to http://web.tmssoftware.com to find out more. On that page, you will find lots of tutorial videos, written blog posts, link to the product documentation. A trial version is also available so that you can find out yourself how much time you will save using TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code. Thanks for watching and see you soon.